Out there. I can see you're upset, Meg. Why don't you tell Uncle Mr. Bones what's wrong?
I did that on my clairvoyance test.
You can't ace every test, Meg. You see, one has different brains. Some brains can talk to each other. We call this ESP.
ESP?
Some brains can lift objects like a baseball. Talk about a fly ball, eh, Meg?
No interruptions!
So who cares if you fail your clairvoyance test? Maybe your brain can throw baseballs, or talk to dead people, or make friends blind. Once we know what your brains can do, we'll know what job to give you. And if your brains are just right, you'll get to sit in the big chair.
What if I don't want the big chair?
Everyone wants the big chair, Meg!
That's why we're all here. Use those brains to listen for once, or the only chair you'll get in is the one with straps.
I wish things had gone differently in Ordinary for us. Wishing won't change things. Finding the projector will.
Ordinary. So much coming together in this one case. A new object of power, something we have not seen before. I mean, coming from me, that's saying something. And the boy, Dylan Faden. Prime Candidate 6. And the sister as well. Once we catch up with her, but the boy, it's so much potential. We're talking Northmore level readings here. And I don't want to invoke his name, but it's completely different circumstances here. It's remarkable.
There was an incident. Yes. Lost a valuable member of our team, yes. Excessive force. Dylan has so much. But he's just a kid. I'll take the blame. He needs some slack. I mean, boys will be boys. He's exceptional and under a lot of stress. Roberts got killed. It's an unfortunate accident, that's all. Marshall needs to realize this. We will make this work. We'll make this work.
Is this what Dylan wanted me to see? It doesn't matter. We need to find that projector. All the times I felt paranoid, I was right. The Bureau could have given me the answers. But they just stood by and watched me.
We used to play there all the time. Me and Dylan, and other kids as well. We loved it. This time, I remember, was different. Way in, deeper into it, like it had shifted. We went inside, and that's where we found the slide projector.
A dump is a place for lost things. Things that have been thrown away. Did you ever feel that way when you were growing up, Jesse?
What?
No.
Yes, but that has nothing to do with...
Was there a slide projector at your home when you were small?
No.
Those were before your time, I suppose. But your family did look at photos together, maybe. In one form or the other?
Maybe.
When was this? Can you remember? At parties? Barbecues? How did it make you feel? Did your parents ever show pictures that embarrassed you? Was alcohol ever involved at these parties? Did your parents drink? Did that make you uncomfortable?
No! That's just stupid. Come on. That has nothing to do with this. Nothing.
This light projector, let me ask you this. As a child, did you ever fantasize about worlds inside pictures? Inside a painting? You know, stepping into a painting, into a hidden world, escaping and finding adventure there, away from your parents.
I don't think so. I don't remember. Maybe. I don't know.
They studied what happened in Ordinary here. That's the place to start looking. Dylan and I were both prime candidates. Both in a cell of some sort. Am I out of the cell now, or is all this, the house and being the director, just another cell? Who's really in charge here? Gotta be a way to rotate these tracks. Maybe there's a control panel nearby. There's gotta be a way to rotate these tracks. Maybe there's a control panel nearby. It won't rotate. Something's blocking it.
America Overnight, celebrating 29 years.
There is a curious correlation with the yet unknowable forces intruding upon our world in the form of altered world events. These forces gravitate toward archetypal objects, a gun, a television, a supposedly haunted house. So clearly humanity affects this process. Our collective unconscious is a map of sorts. We hold the key, but we don't know how to use it. We create these archetypes through everyday life, popular culture, urban legends, but we are observing and influencing a complicated system in action. We can change the likelihood of something being a receptacle for these forces just by thinking about it. But we haven't found a method to control the outcome. And yet, there's something unique in us, in our dreams, in the conceptual reality with power, with our minds. What's the cause and what's the effect? Are we the starting point or just a necessary evil in this? A byproduct, a reflection, a projection? We'll struggle to find the answers to these hard questions, or die trying.
Evaluation of Dylan Faden, formerly P6, performed by Dr. Calderon. Let's begin then. In a single word, describe the world around you.
Where's Casper?
Dr. Darling is out of the building today.
He's never out. He didn't want to come, did he? He never visits, not since Roberts. To tell Darling it wasn't my fault. I couldn't control it yet, but I can now. I learned. Will you tell him?
In a single word, describe the world around you.
A prison. A cold, empty prison. Not even a poster on the wall.
Mm-hmm. What is the next number in the sequence 3, 6, 9, 12, 15?
18.
What day is it today?
How the hell would I know? It's not like you give me a calendar.
You find a rabbit in the woods. It is breathing, but not moving. You cannot see any blood. What do you do?
Leave it.
Expand on that.
It doesn't matter. The rabbit's not real. None of it's real.
What day is it today?
Do you have questions that can't be answered? Is this what gets you up in the morning? What you dreamed of doing as a scared, stupid little girl?
Can you describe a dog to me?
In ordinary, we had a friend. Nosebleed Neil. And when it all went crazy, you know what I mean. Nosebleed Neil turned into a dog. Or something like a dog.
What day is it tomorrow?
Fuck off! I don't know! There is no calendar! How can I fucking know?
Dylan, calm down.
Fuck you! Fuck you and fuck Casper! Hey! Are you watching this, you old fuck? Did you send your bitch because you're too scared of me? Where is Casper?
Security, get a team in here. I need...
See what they have on ordinary. It's all here. Our home, our school, the woods, the dump. found the slide projector in the dump outside town. Did they recreate that too? Is that where they keep it? They say when you visit your childhood home, everything feels small, miniature, not real. They got that right.
You mentioned a poem last time we talked. By Thomas Zane?
Yes. Beyond the shadow you settle for. There's a miracle illuminated. I look for a
poet by that name. I did find a European filmmaker who moved here in the 60s, named Thomas Zane.
What?
I don't...
No matter.
It suits you very well, the poem. How you see things. Maybe you wrote it yourself?
I didn't.
No matter. You've said a few times that you feel like there's a piece of you missing. Can we talk about that?
Okay. Yeah, it's this. I feel an emptiness, a yearning for something that I think I lost.
It's natural for you to feel that way. Your brother and your parents are dead.
No! No! Doolin's not dead. And that's not even it.
You're referring to the imaginary friend from your childhood?
Polaris. She's come back. After a long time, she's calling me. In a dream I saw, she showed me things.
Jesse.
It felt more real than anything. As real as what happened in Ordinary.
The industrial accident in your hometown? That you believe Polaris caused.
No, it wasn't an accident. There was no industrial accident, and Polaris didn't cause it. She saved me and Dylan.
Jesse.
No, it was a cover-up. The government knows about it. There were agents there. Agents from, I don't know exactly, but they took Dylan. They, I'll find them. I won't stop looking. Polaris wants me to go to New York. There's a building there. I have to leave soon. I have to be there at a very specific time. Something hugely important is going to happen.
Jesse, you know we can't let you go until you're well. And that begins by understanding what's real and what's imagined.
Moved the whole of New York, and nobody saw a thing. Pretty unbelievable.
Thank you.
We should check that lab.
Effective immediately. I'm setting up a new department. Dimensional research in the research sector. Transferring the slide projector there. That's where my focus will be now. The ordinary site remains as is. We'll be back to... I don't know when.
Darling took the projector to the research sector. He dedicated a whole area to it, so he knew it was important. Dimensional research. That's where we go next.
Contact the janitor if you need to get through.
Broken? How many dead ends can this place have? We need to find Ati. No, Artie. Where is he?
Now this boy left, said the son of Annikki Tähti. My assistant will keep work in the glove and the house standing. Lomille lomps, holiday homps.
How can anyone even get out of here while the building's sealed? Let alone go on a holiday. Guess I'm about to find out.
Okay.